Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Yessik here again today to bring you another episode of Let's Play Chasm Alpha. Anyways, as you can see, it's version 0.42 now, which means my save was actually wiped, but I played up to the point that I was at before with a few notable differences, which I will show you right away. I saved up a lot of my money and I actually bought myself a scimitar, which is the same as the short sword but with a lot more damage. I got the magic axe. I happened to get some lucky drops with a lifting belt and a jade ring and some quilted armor. Still don't have any head armor, but the magic axe, of course, you recognize from Castlevania, and the scimitar looks more or less like this. Cost me 2,500, but I am happy to make the purchase because it's, well, I don't know if it's pretty good because I just got it before I started. So as you can see, this is now my layout for the maps. I'm in the catacombs. I haven't explored that one area I can jump to in the far right, which is maybe the only difference between the two save files. So now the only question is, how exactly do I want to go about getting to this place? I could teleport and then go across, or I could go down to the right and then use a couple shortcuts. I think maybe down to the right is the best option. So I'm gonna go with that, and while I'm at it, I'm gonna kill the hell out of these guys. I want to level up strength one more time so I can just kill even more things in one hit. I only just got the scimitar and I'm pretty pleased with it. Although it only brings my attack up to 19 as opposed to the broadsword that did 20 and cost 1,500 more. So if I had the option again, I'd probably just go with the broadsword. Not to mention I do like the big sweeping swing on the broadsword. So I say I'm happy with it. I'm actually slightly displeased with it, but you know, that is nothing really matters. Anyone can see, nothing really matters but me. I know it's to me. I'm just singing my own narcissistic version of the song, or actually somebody else's narcissistic version of the song that I have just subconsciously taken credit for. I guess my favorite narcissistic version of the song might be a better way of putting it. Honestly, I never even saw the original being sung. It was some guy doing opera on Do You Think You or America's Got Talent? I say one of my least favorite shows, but I really don't watch much TV at all, so almost that can pretty much mean any show at all, one of my least favorite shows. Also, really not a big fan of reality TV in general, and I think they count as reality, those shows that are like contests, even though it's very unreal. Oh, honestly, the whole definition of reality TV is kind of confusing to me. Here's one of these sacrificial altars. I don't have 500 I can give up, and I don't know what happens when you give up experience there. Like, does it give you an item? Does it give you a power? Does it give you a spell? I will have to check it out when I have either 500 or 1,000. Although I'd like to instantly give 1,000, just because, giving 1,000 would be incredibly useful. Oh yeah, so I have to thank either Rezevil or Razevil, depending on what he's going for with his name there, for telling me how to progress in the game, because I was entirely stuck and I probably wouldn't have made progress for a long time or figured this out, even though the solution is actually rather simple and I really should have figured it out. 2 hits for those guys, that is not bad at all. 3 hits for those rat chambers. I guess I could actually farm at least some experience off those rat nests. They do eventually stop spawning enemies, though. I know this because I tried to farm experience off them. I basically ended up farming a lot of things in order to get the 2,500, where I could have just spent 1,000 and then leveled up 2 times. I say I'm pleased, I'm actually kind of disappointed by that. Need 100 more S before I can level up, and it's catacombs time. Which is a bit like, I was gonna say Ripping Time, a reference to the Ripping Friends, which even when I was a kid that was supposed to appeal to, really did not appeal to me at all. Okay, so what I'm supposed to do is latch on to this and then jump across like that. So, rather simple, elegant solution if I do say so myself. I'm still very disappointed in myself for not noticing that that was what I needed to do. Kind of upsetting, really. So I'm in part 2 of the catacombs now. I catacombs, if you know what I mean. How much health do these guys have, I wonder? They are clearly a different type. They still die in just 2 hits. That's rather nice. I'm glad I got a better weapon for this area, at least. and I get these little holes in the wall with which to attack. Hey, a yellow leaf. I think that might actually be the first yellow leaf I've actually picked up in this game. Pretty exciting, if I do say so myself. Okay. So, a big pit of spikes, a big pit of spite. It kind of is a big pit of spite. If this isn't spiteful, I don't know what is. It's like, clearly that was put there to kill somebody. Or everybody. Which, in my opinion, is a rather spiteful way of going about things. Hey, a mob trap room. I have to sneeze. That really sucks. Whoa, boomerang skeleton and spitting guy. This is actually quite... Okay, no, he spits bees. Wow, I'm just taking a lot of damage here because I'm freaking out a bit. Okay. So that's a bee nest then, right? That's a bee mine. Okay, so I killed you pretty quickly there. Three hits, jump, kill the bees. Okay, I'm all good. I stopped freaking out after a little bit there, and everything turned out all right. Now, the last wave was considerably easier than the second last wave. Slightly disappointing. I do have some potions in case I need them, which I'm assuming... Oh, God. Little platforms with spikes on them, and then this. I don't trust this at all. I don't know what it is, but I don't trust it. It doesn't look like anything else from the culture we're supposedly exploring. There's no path down and right. That looks like a boss room indicator, that flag there. Is this a boss? Maybe there's an item I have to use or I have to have? Oh yeah, I should really be using my magic axe more often too. Or else I'll just forget it exists, which I pretty much will no matter what. I will no matter what. I am will. Will I am. Oh Jesus, okay, 10 damage and I almost died. What I could use at this point is a fire pit, so I can heal myself a bit. I can successfully do that platforming, or it's possible, but I do not like the looks of it. What's over here? Some ghost things? You know, these I can deal with. They only take 2 hits. They give a lot of experience. Get me the fuck out of here. Okay. Wanna go, ghost thing? I gotcha so bad. Okay, you know, it's making me nervous that I'm not healing here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use a health potion. I realized that was maybe a huge waste of a health potion, and I should have waited for... Really should have waited for, like, a boss fight or something, and just gone back to use the health potion elsewhere. The sand is really goddamn annoying. Like, I'm not entirely sure how I'm supposed to get out of it. Come on, ghost. Perfect. Like, as far as I know, you just kind of tap until you're out, but then you don't have a full jump. Which is kind of annoying in itself. Well, I'm glad I healed. Because this is looking like a bunch of bullshit. Okay, you die, then you two also have to die, but, you know, you can take your time at it. The first guy had to rush. I needed him gone right away. Just don't want to lose this 800 experience. That's enough to level me up. Ow, that's a big area. How much are you guys willing to bet that this is a shortcut to the underground area that I couldn't get to before? Fire pit, yes! Thank you for healing me. And now I actually have to craft as well. I need another potion. Well, if I hadn't used the potion, I would have been in a really bad state. Let me see, this comes out in the cave area. No, more mines, huh? Wow, I'm just rushing through this. Not taking the scenic route at all. What's down here? Oh. A cup? Oh. Well, now I'm down here. I just missed everything that possibly could have happened there. I even didn't take the note, which I'm kind of regretting now, I must admit. And These are dissolving blocks. Okay, you can jump through them though. That's good to know. That block's actually... Are you fucking kidding me? I really should have grabbed onto that ledge. Do you guys not do you guys disagree? Platforming is becoming a bit tougher in this, I must admit. Specifically, that jump is kind of bullshit. Okay, now I have to make this stupid thing again, and... Oh, jeez, almost freaked out and just ran off the edge there. Okay, at least I can't really fall by doing that. Oh, I'm so glad I made that last jump. Can you imagine going all that way and then not making the last jump? And I think this is back out to... Like, I'm almost back at that area that I was exploring before. What's this? Another path? Where the fuck does this lead? Jesus, sorry, there's so many paths, I just want to explore them all. Gotta explore them all, Pathamon. It's like Pokemon, but with more pathing. The Pokemon are a lot better pathed. Like, StarCraft 2 versus StarCraft 3 levels of pathing. I don't even know what that means. I mean, StarCraft 1 versus StarCraft 2. Did you see how bad the pathing was in StarCraft 1? That shit sucked. Everybody just lined up and marched. Bad idea. Okay, anyways, I'm getting back up out of here, because... I think that maybe I should explore a zone or something, you know how it is? Oh, it's some sort of code puzzle. And then you have to pull the lever and then it maybe opens a door? So like, what are they all worth or where are they? Interesting. Okay, let me see. Felix's journal. Everything is going to shambles. Nidan was certain he had cracked the combination after days of working on it, but a trap door was triggered when he pulled the lever. He fell until I could no longer hear his screams. I dropped a torch down, but I could not see the bottom. I'll wait a while longer to see if Marcus and Jorat come back, and then I'm searching for another way out of here. That sucks. Don't know exactly what the combination would be, but hey, more plants. That's kind of cool, you know, since I just made another potion. Fairly excited about that. Is this the way to the other cave? The other cave. I'll take your dreams away, or something like that. Another day? Well, you always gotta love rotating spike ball chain traps. A coin purse, I wonder what that does. Check it out. Equipment, Jade Ring just increases my luck. Is coin purse just a... Inventory. Oh, it's just treasure. Cool. That'll probably be worth a fair amount if I ever make it back to town. Okay. Got out. Well, this place is bigger than I had expected. For some reason, I was expecting a rather small area, but I'm not sure why. Really, I should have expected nothing smaller than the first area. Hey, nice crit. That was all due to the luck upgrade, clearly. I should not have jumped over there just to get one hit on this guy. I really need to get on this. Oh, no, don't do damage to me. One damage is enough, isn't it, for you? One damage doesn't really matter, anyone can see, but you know, if you do it twice, I'll kind of be angry and upset and just not have fun. Oh, Turtles in Time, anybody? That was Turtles in Time that had the, like, water spike things, right? Wow. Dem traps. Dem... Ow. Fairly... Oh shit, okay, I'm getting out of here. Oh my god, 5 health left. Was there a fire pit anywhere nearby? Can I get back to town somehow? Okay, treasure. Hopefully this isn't trapped treasure. Leather bracer. I don't think I'm getting back to town, so I'm gonna have to use my other potion. Sucks, but dem's the breaks. No. It's just another clay pot. Goodbye, other clay pot. This place was only for treasure. It was indeed only for treasure. I was just checking to see if there was anything else. Kinda like the whole Turtles in Time shit going on here, actually. Like, it made it sound like I was complaining. No, I'm a big fan of that reference. I like it. It's at least one of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle side-scrolling action games. And I won't have to come this way again, so no more dealing with these stupid-ass sand rooms. Ugh. So goddamn annoying. Let me jump. Let me jump. Jump, children. It's just a jump away. It's... Okay, so important note, if you want to cling onto the ledge, you have to continue holding the direction you want to cling to. It's important to note because fuck everything. There we go. Get myself another box. Have a lot of experience here. And a lot of different coins. I'm not entirely displeased by... Oh, okay, I can't stay on those while it comes around and swings at me. So, it shoots, I slide. Oh, okay, maybe I should slide twice if it shoots. I'm taking so much damage. Please give me a fire pit. I just need a fire pit to love me. I mean, somebody to love me. Please, fire pit, give me love. Give me love, baby, don't fire me. Don't fire me no more. Which is why it's a bad idea to date your boss. Just conflict of interest, really. Or maybe it's a really good idea to date your boss. I don't know. That was a bit of a platforming thing. It wasn't too difficult, but you know. Whoa! Can you just not do that? Wow. This guy's a bitch. I really am not enjoying him. It's like he's trying to find a temple or something, like Indiana Jones, but... Now that I've seen that, I kind of know how I was supposed to make that jump. You guys move surprisingly fast. For skeletons. You know, they don't have any muscles. How do they move that fast? Always remember, there's certain jumps you're supposed to make by hanging off ledges. And when I say always remember, I'm talking to me, I'm not talking to you guys. I'm sure I will be reminded in the comments. A long episode. So close to death. I get a leather whip. Oh, hells yeah. Oh, it does so little damage. Okay, what if I equipped it to this instead and went all melee since I have some... Oh, look at the range on that thing. Look at the range. The range is amazing. I'm very happy about this whip. I can hit things from a distance. Can I whip up? No. And here is where I could quite possibly die. I didn't. So that's alright, I guess. Whew. I need to go to the fire pit. I need to heal up. Or, you know, I can just do what appears to be quite a difficult platforming puzzle. Don't worry about it at all. It's fine, really. Good to know I can kill those bees in one whip, because I don't want to get near bees. I fucking hate bees. Actually, no! That's actually my first death in this game. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe. I realized that I had kind of ADD throughout that. I didn't manage to focus on anything, really. But it was a fun episode nonetheless. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.